Darkness is not dark to you, O Lord.
The night is bright as the day. Darkness and light to you are both alike.
Your grief of God is as eternal as your love. You yourself weep for us in our sadness. The sorrow in our lives is felt in your own heart, as you always reach towards us in compassion. Reach for us now and be our very present help in this time of darkness. Speak to us, God. Comfort, heal, and restore us.
Amen.
O God, whose beloved Son took children into his arms and blessed them, give us grace to entrust all whose lives have been taken away by the way of violence to your never failing care and love. Bring us all into your heavenly kingdom through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Most merciful God, whose wisdom is beyond our understanding, deal graciously with all families who have lost loved ones in their grief. We remember especially, and please add your names of those who you would like to remember. Surround them with your love, that they may not be overwhelmed by their loss, but have confidence in your goodness and strength to meet the days to come through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
O God, make speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help us.
Glory to the Father,
to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Alleluia. Child of the light, I long to follow Jesus. I set the stars to give light to the world. The star of my life is Jesus. In him there is no darkness at all. The night and the day, the Lamb is the light of the city of God. Shine in my heart, Lord Jesus. I want to see the brightness of God. I want to look at Jesus. Your Son of Righteousness, shine on and show me the way to our Father. In him there is no darkness at all. The night and the day are both alike. The Lamb is the light of the city of God. Shine in my heart, Lord Jesus. For the coming of Christ, I want to be with Jesus. When we have run with patience the race, we shall know the joy of Jesus. In him there is no darkness at all. The night and the day are both alike.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride, beautifully dressed for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Look, God's dwelling place is now among the people, and he will dwell with them. They will be his people, and God himself will be with them and be their God. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death, or mourning, or crying, or pain, for the old order of things has passed away." He who was seated on the throne said, "I am making everything new." Then he said, "Write this down, for these words are trustworthy and true." He said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty I will give water without cost from the spring of the water of life. Those who are victorious will inherit all this, and I will be their God, and they will be my children." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Oh, there's no place like home for the holidays. Because no matter how far away you go, if you want to be happy in a million ways, for the holidays, you can't be home, sweet home. I heard this song on the radio on the way home a couple of evenings ago, and the images that came to my mind were the Christmas fantasy many of us are raised with. A warm and inviting Norman Rockwell house, a cheerful, well-dressed family around a beautifully set table, which is full of beautiful foods. A Christmas tree in the background, piled with perfectly wrapped presents. There was no hint of messiness, chaos, emotional distress, all the ways we and our families fall short. It is a moment held out as something to aspire to, a fantasy no one can quite grasp. If we can't quite achieve this, the advertisers whisper, is it really Christmas? Jesus, in fact, invites us all home for the holidays, but it's not a cheery Christmas house we are invited to. No, the home we are invited to is a stable full of messy animals and farmhands, a borrowed feeding trough instead of a crib, and the crowds packed in the back room so full that there is no room for them at the inn, full of an occupying army that has forced everyone to move around just to heads for further oppressive taxation. Joseph and Mary have no control over this birth, no agency. It's loud and messy and dirty. So whatever your circumstances, this stable that is here ready for Christmas tells all of us that we are home for this holy day. Wherever your life has taken you this year, whatever toll 2020 has taken on you, coronavirus related or not, you are home, here, at this stable, with Jesus. For a Messiah is born to us not in the privileged rooms of a palace, but under threat of violence, with illness, poverty and death stalking this family outside the walls of this rough shelter. Whatever has grieved you, burdened you, left you without solace or comfort this year, here at this table, you are home. Jesus is waiting for you, a true Messiah born into our own flesh, a Messiah that knows pain, hunger, loss, death. There there is nothing that you cannot go down at the foot of the cross and let him carry. 2020 is a good year to let our Christmas fantasies go. It has laid bare the cracks in our society. It has shown us that the only Messiah worth trusting is the one coming among us, Emmanuel. Come to this table going into the holidays and be healed.
Let us say Psalm 91 together in unison. He who dwells in the shelter of the Most High abides under the shadow of the Almighty.
He shall say to the Lord, "You are my refuge and my stronghold, my God in whom I put my trust.
He will deliver you from the snare of the
hunter and from the deadly pestilence.
He shall cover you with his pinions,
and
you shall find refuge under his wings.
His
faithfulness shall be a shield and buckler.
You shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor
of the plague that stalks in the darkness,
nor
of the sickness
that is wasted in the day.
A thousand shall fall at your side, and 10,000 at your right hand.
But it shall not come to you.
Your eyes have only to behold,
to
see the reward of the wicked, because you have made the Lord your refuge, and the Most High your habitation. There shall no evil happen to you, neither shall any plague come near your dwelling.
For
he shall give his angels charge over you,
to keep you in all your ways.
They shall bear you in their hands, lest you dash your foot against a stone.
You shall tread upon
the lion. You shall trample the young lion and the serpent under your feet.
Because
he is bound to me in love, therefore will I deliver him.
I will protect
him because he knows my name.
He
shall call upon me, and I will answer him.
I
am with him in trouble.
I will rescue
him and bring him to honor.
With long life will I satisfy him
and show him my salvation.
We light this Advent candle to remember those persons whom we have loved and lost. We pause to remember their names, their faces, their voices. We give thanks for the memory that binds them to us this season which anticipates Christmas. May God's eternal love
surround them. So
we We light the second candle to redeem the pain of loss, the loss of relationships, the loss of jobs, the loss of hope. As we gather up the pain of the past, we offer it to you, O God, asking that into your open hands, you will place the gift of peace.
Refresh, restore, renew us, O God, and lead us into your future.
Remember the poignancy of memories, the grief, sadness, the hurts, the pain of reflecting on our own mortality. Let us remember that
dawn defeats darkness.
This fourth candle is lit to remember our faith and the gift of hope which God offers to us in the Christmas story. We remember that God, who shares our life, also promises us a place and a time where pain and suffering will be no more.
Let us remember the one who shows the way and who goes with us into our sorrows.
Thank you. your word to those who work or watch or read this night, and give your angels charge over those who sleep. Tend the sick, Lord Christ, give rest to the weary, bless the dying, soothe the suffering, pity the afflicted, shield the joyous, and all for your love's sake.
Amen.
Join me in reading the prayer of St. Chrysostom.
Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time, with one accord, to make our common supplication to you. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in your name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world of knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting.
Amen.
Be your channel of love, there is hatred in our love, where there is injury, our pardon, Lord, and where there is doubt and faith in to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love with all my soul. Make me a channel of your peace.
Scatter the darkness from before your path, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain always.
Amen.
Let us go forth into the world rejoicing in the power of the Spirit.
Thanks be to God.